Yo, Sanjay Uchiha here, people giving you my review on Samurai Jack Season 5, Episode 6. I'm going to try and make this one a quick one because I'm starving and would love to get some food. So, continuing off last week's episode where we saw Jack split up from Ashi, it was really interesting watching this episode because it almost felt as if Ashi was put in the position of Jack as a wanderer in the previous seasons. But instead of traveling around to help people, Ashi's put in a position where she meets all the people Jack has already helped from like 50 years prior. So, to say the least, that in itself makes the episode very interesting. It presents a very interesting dynamic. And to our surprise, that's the basic synopsis of the episode, really and truly. But throughout the episode, we actually get the return of Scaramouche from, I believe, episode 1, was it? If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I never expected him to return. So the whole subplot there was really for him to actually make his way to Aku to tell him that Jack has lost his sword. But and it was a source of comedy in the episode, honestly, but it never really fulfills... he never really fulfills his purpose and actually doesn't make it to Aku for, I guess, and that's favorable for Jack, so there's that. But I must say, it was fun seeing Ashi going around meeting all the people Jack has already saved, and I vaguely remember all of these groups from the previous seasons, to say the least. I'm like, oh shit, yeah, I remember that. Especially when she came up to the bar with the DJ samurai. Like, it was only when he flashback that I remembered. So it was awesome seeing all these cameos. Well, I don't know if they'll be considered cameos, but yeah, you get the point. But yeah, the episode, as usual, it was very well paced. And I think a lot of people probably had to say that they weren't comfortable with the fact that Ashi like completely did a 180 in one episode. So I felt this episode helped to helped with her character development and helped turning her from the quote-unquote dark side to the good side, even though she had mostly made the change from last week's episode. But I felt this episode did wonders in solidifying or cementing her change. And it was symbolic seeing her, because we got a flashback at one point where we see her mom explaining, in essence, what Aku is and that they too should be a part of his source, where he comes from, the darkness, apparently. So the scene really revolves around her mom pushing her off into this pit of tar, or I don't know what to call it, quote unquote darkness. So it was very symbolic when we see her actually diving in to what appears to be darkness, but it's really just a little lake there, and she cleans off. Surprisingly, it's just really like tar or whatever on her body, so she's been naked all along, really and truly. So it was very symbolic, and it was essentially the confirmation that, you know, she's fully made the change from the dark to the good side, and she's ready to support Jack. So I thought that really added to the quality of the episode. Excellent writing, as usual. Of course, after Ashi has basically seen and met all the people that Jack's helped, we actually see her come across this mysterious figure that points her in the direction that Jack has headed. So, and it's at this point that we see Jack in, I guess you could call it a cemetery with all these ghostly samurai figures, even though they seemingly, one of them could seemingly materialize and become physical. But it's at this point that we see Jack, apparently he's ready to resign himself to death, committing, what do you call it, seppuku? Yeah, seppuku. So yeah, so that was a very good nod to, you know, the whole samurai culture. I loved it. It definitely added. It was very interesting. Like, I'm just having fun watching this season. So it's really through the development that Ashi has gotten that she proceeds to actually try and convince Jack to, you know, there's still hope. He's inspired a lot of people to basically stand against Aku if he ever needs them. So it's really through her actions that Jack is convinced, you know, continue the fight. And he makes the decision that, hey, it's time to find his sword. And I think it's about the right time. I think the season's pacing itself really well, because next week's episode 7, I believe we're scheduled to have 10 episodes, so provided he gets his sword by episode 7, and I would assume that he's going to rally all the people that he's helped in the past, and then he'll be proceeding to have a final showdown with Aku. Aku and his forces, more than likely, so I believe that will be the case. That's my little prediction there. But all in all, it was an amazing episode, as usual. Like, it's just impossible to give any of these episodes less than 9 out of 10. Like, it's insane what the quality is. But if you've watched the episode, let me know what you think. Subscribe for more. Subscribing helps, I suppose. Check out my other content. I do AMVs, Dragon Ball content, Naruto/Boruto content, so check them out, let me know what you think. Let's talk in the comment section, and I'll see you in the next one, people.